AI agents are a trending topic. Let's explore RAG, a popular technique used to bring real-time context and accurate information to LLMs through two lenses. We'll look at traditional RAG for those of you who maybe haven't yet become familiar with it. And then we'll switch and look at the future, which is agentic RAG, which is starting to become more of a topic. And we'll do all of this in DataStax Langflow. So come into DataStax Langflow and we have just an empty flow here. And we'll just model RAG, right? And we'll model RAG by starting like at the very basic. So we'll have a chat input and we'll have a language model. So let's use OpenAI just because it's fairly common. And of course, an output. And this is not RAG. This is just like talking to an LLM, right? This is just very familiar conversation with an LLM. And we just like map input to the input and we take the output and we map it like this. We go to the playground and we just say hi. But let's choose actually a cheaper model. So let's choose 3.5 Turbo. And we'll be like, hi, what movie won the Oscar for Best Picture in 2024? And the reason I'm asking this is because we're talking to 3.5 Turbo, right? And it doesn't know. It's like I'm unable to provide real-time information. And that's sort of what you'd expect with an older model and maybe a cheaper model. But how do we bring this into 2024? How do we introduce real-time context and remove hallucinations? Well, RAG. And for those of you who know RAG, feel free to skip this. But for those who don't, RAG stands for Retrieval Augmented Generation. So we retrieve some data. We inject it into the prompt, some real-time context, and we use it to augment or change the generated output. What does that look like? Let's look at it real quick. So what we can do is get rid of this playground, and let's just augment this a little bit. So what we're going to do is, What we're going to do is let's go back and add some stuff between the input and the LLM. This is essentially RAG, right? So we'll create a prompt first, and we'll sort of give the prompt to the LLM. But what is the prompt? Well, the prompt needs to contain two things. Real-time context. So use this context, and we'll make a variable context to answer the question from the user, and we'll say question. So these are two variables. You can see prompt variables right here. And we'll check and save. So all right, we have the user's question, but we need to get like real-time context from somewhere. Thankfully, there's data, and we can just go read some URL and get its text content and give it as context right there, okay? So where are we gonna go look for Oscar winners? Well, the British Film Institute has like literally a blog post titled Oscars 2024. So I think this is a fairly decent document. So we'll paste this. And now we're gonna read this into the prompt, get the user's question wired up. And this is basically RAG, right? So we retrieve from here, we inject it in the prompt and it augments the generated output. So let's go to the playground and ask the same thing. So we'll do this, send. And now like magic, the movie Oppenheimer, this is so cool. Okay, and so now let's again, let's be like, tell me more about the Oscars 2024. And we should see, like suddenly just knows a bunch of stuff. It's so cool, okay. So RAG's cool. It's worth noting this doesn't change the model, right? The model is a frozen big piece of data, right? It's like multiple gigabytes, probably 60 or more. And we're not touching the model. We're just prompt engineering. We're introducing like new context with retrieving data from the British Film Institute in this case. This is RAG, okay? What might agentic RAG look like? Well, Langflow actually is really great to show you agents. Langflow has first-class support for agents. Before we do this, we need to define agents. Agents, as defined by many folks, as defined by Paul Klein IV, founder of Browser Base on the Contagious Code podcast, agents are when an LLM models agency. Like as human beings, we have agency when we have choice. We get to choose what tool to use for a job. Similarly, when an LLM can, with agency, just choose the right tool to use, it becomes an agent. So freedom over intuition, freedom over tool choice is what makes an agent, gives the LLM agency to choose the right tool for the job. Indeed, we can model agentic RAG by giving a retriever tool to an agent and saying, you know, use this when you feel like it with agency, okay? So let's look at how we can model this in Langflow. So if we go to Langflow, exit the playground, we're going to get rid of most of this. Actually, let's just get rid of all of this. So we'll just get rid of everything, and start afresh, okay? We'll start with an agent, just an agent right there. It's an agent. And an agent, as you can see, can work with multiple model providers. We're going to work with the OpenAI provider. We'll use the cheaper model, and we'll give it the OpenAI API key. That's it. Now, this agent's cool. In fact, here we can just give it a chat output and talk to it if we want to. And let's see if we can ask. We need a chat input as well. We'll just do that right there. We'll give it the input. And let's see if we can ask now the same prompt, right? And now, I mean, we're still talking to the same language model. It just doesn't have tools. It's an agent without tools. So I apologize for the confusion. It keeps context. This is all right. But let's maybe start a new chat. Let's do a new chat and let's ask here. And this chat, of course, is completely divorced of context. Doesn't know, right? I see that the current date is 2024 and the Oscars for that year have not yet taken place yet. Yeah, that's an agent without tools. Let's do Agentic RAG by giving it the tool to go browse the web, okay? And so let's look at that. So let's go here and I'm just going to go back and add our tool. So we'll go to the URL. And again, notice how there's file and webhook and SQL. You could literally just turn a PDF or something into a tool. But for now, let's turn the URL into tool mode and just say, here's a tool, use it. And I don't know if it's going to search for the British search with the British Film Institute or something, but I just gave it a tool and I'm like, use it when you feel the need to use it. Let's send this request. And so now it's going to exercise some agency or not. It just gets the time zone. Well, let's maybe ask it to search the web. Search the web to find out. And now, you know, you can use the attached URL tool. While trying to access the Oscars website. What happened here? So here, it's going to oscars.org, access denied. Unfortunately, that website doesn't like bots. So let's be even more specific. Look it up at bfi.org, which is the British Film Institute, I think. Yes, bfi.org.uk. And, you know, we're getting a little bit specific, but all this can also be inferred using other tools. It's just like modeling Agentic RAG for you here on the BFI website. Okay, well, it just looked at bfi.org.uk. I'm just going to paste the actual link here, and then we'll see. Which movie won the Oscar for Best Picture in 2024? Find out on this, right? I just gave it the full link. And again, we're using 3.5, so maybe it isn't really good at, like, reasoning, right? And coming up with... And now, after all this, we have some agentic RAG, the movie Oppenheimer. One, because it literally went to that website. It also received 7 Oscars. Yeah, now suddenly it knows a lot more. And so the agent's ability to even come up with the sites to search also depends on the quality of the LLM. So let's maybe use a more capable model and see what happens. So now let's go use the big model, GPT-4o, which is pretty capable. And let's give it no further hints. So let's just say, not even look it up. Let's just say search the internet if you don't know, right? And we'll send it. And so now the flow is running. It's going to maybe call the tool. There we go. And the movie Oppenheimer. And let's see what happened. So it went looking straight to this, but you might say, oh, look, that's also all the text. You might say, okay, well, that's context. Let's just start a new chat. I agree with you. Let's go to this. We'll do a new one. And we'll start the chat. And we'll see, completely without any context, what's happening. Okay, so this is brand new. It didn't know, but now it went looking for the thing on Wikipedia on the 96th Academy Awards. And so this is completely devoid of my input. And it just read all of Wikipedia. And it said Oppenheimer won the movie for Best Picture. Give me today's news headlines in Germany. And it's going to probably go use the tool. Let's explore this again. And the cool thing about Agentic RAG is, because of agency, I don't have to give the URL, right? It's a new level of inference quality. And so there you go. This is some stuff here. Apparently, global coal use is a record high. I wish we get renewables. But in any case, let's look at what happened under the hood. So the time zone was Europe, Berlin, and here, checked out all the German sources. And it's an array too. I wouldn't even think to come up with an array. And it got the text content, read all of this, like an agent with agency. And then at the very end, we got these. So Agentic RAG is a step up from traditional RAG. Langflow is the best builder and tester for Agentic RAG. You just saw that, right? I didn't write any code. I just built something. And now I can expose it to my web application. Of course, I have to show you how to close the loop. If you come to Langflow and click on this API button, you get an endpoint and you can generate a token to query that exact flow, agentic flow, from any either front-end or back-end or application. It's that simple. Of course, it's open source and you can self-host it. What I just showed you was hosted on DataStax. In any case, I hope this has been useful for you as you dive into RAG, specifically agentic RAG, and more. We can't wait to see what you build. Thank you, and I'll see you in the next one.